Well, good evening, everyone.
Hey, welcome to the 2009 Homecoming Coronation. My name is Mr. Lukens.
And I'm Mrs. Weltlaufer. And we will be emceeing tonight's event.
And for those of you who haven't been around Roosevelt this week, we've had a pretty cool homecoming week, I'd say. What do you guys think? It's kids. And it's really kind of hard to believe that this week is already coming to an end so quickly, you know.
We really had a great week so far. The excitement started to build at the nomination assembly 2 weeks ago when the night at the museum theme was revealed.
And then since then, you know, the excitement in this building has just reached a crescendo, don't you think?
I agree.
At a fever pitch, an incredible fever pitch, a level of excitement rarely seen in any high school anywhere. Can't you just feel it?
Yes. Mr. Lukens, settle down. He's very excited. While you get yourself under control here, Mr. Lukens, let's do a quick review of the week we've had. Monday started out with Western Day. And I don't know if anybody noticed, but Mr. Lukens actually rode his horse to school on Monday. You did, didn't you? Just like you were in high school, right?
Well, let's just take it easy on me there, little lady.
Yeah, okay.
Let's see if I can get a little love from the audience. How many of you ever ridden a horse? How many of you know what a horse is? How many of you have ever been to a parade? Okay, just a little suggestion. When you leave tonight, you might want to watch your step when you get into the parking lot.
Oh. Well, hopefully they picked that up since Monday. I don't know. Well, okay, let's get back on task. Tuesday brought us to Security Day. It was really fun to see so many people getting to spare by dressing up in so many creative security ways. At your age, Mr. Lukens, that extra security around here probably made you pretty feel safe, right?
Yeah, as I'm hobbling around the hallways, I felt actually quite safe with the security here. And speaking of getting back on task, Wednesday was Caveman Day here at Roosevelt. Yeah. And unlike my partner here, because I'm such a gentleman and such a good friend of yours, Mrs. Weltlaufer, I won't even think of asking you something like, so what was life like before the wheel and the fire was invented, Mrs. Weltlaufer?
Ooh.
No, I won't say that. And if you can't remember, I'm sure I can probably help you with that one. My high school graduation photo is chiseled in a piece of rock somewhere. Yeah.
It's not that bad, really. It's not that bad. Yeah. Well, today was probably the coolest day of all. Today was Egyptian dress-up day. And we had some very early Egyptian civilization dresses here at RHS. Man, it would have been great to be living around that time when you could wear a toga and everything was white. And as a math person, finding the volume of a pyramid is really awesome. I really don't have much to work with here, so, okay, yeah.
Well, you know what one pyramid said to the other? I want my mummy! All right. Okay. I think it's time we wrap up this lame part of the evening and get on with the show, don't you think?
Yeah.
All right. It's time to meet the parents of our underclassmen homecoming representatives, so let's get this started.
All right. For the freshmen, we have Carl and Deanne Sullivan, and those are the parents of Kara.
And she's being escorted by Kelsey Sullivan. This is Kara's sister, actually. That's not Carl, that's Kelsey. And we also have Sylvester and Tracy Clark, the parents of Jeremiah.
Don and Jody Garcia are the parents of sophomore Isabella.
And Roger and Juanita Smith are the parents of Andy.
For the juniors, we have Dave DeBoer and Pam DeBoer, and those are the parents of Haley.
And we have Darnell and Ann Nelson are the parents of Ben. And now here are our freshman representatives, Kara Sullivan and Jeremiah Clark.
Kara is involved with competitive cheer and would love to be able to fly so she wouldn't have to drive.
Okay, Jeremiah plays football and basketball. He says he runs into a lot of things, but that works pretty well for him when he's playing defense on the football field.
Congratulations, Kara and Jeremiah. Now introducing our sophomore representatives, we have Isabella Garcia and Andy Smith.
And Isabella is involved with Teddy, Student Council, Renaissance, Chorus, Track, Theater, and Spanish Club, and she says she hasn't watched TV for years.
Andy plays football, basketball, and baseball. He once ate a ladybug and contributes that to his ease in dealing with the ladies at RHS.
I see a lot of people writing that down out there,
right, yeah.
Actually, right now. Congratulations to Isabella and Andy. And now let's introduce our junior class representatives, Haley DeBoer and Ben Nelson.
Haley is a football cheerleader and also runs track. She enjoys performing in talent shows and pep rallies, but would like to have the superpower of being invisible if given the choice.
And Ben plays baseball and basketball, and he loves homecoming week because all the excitement builds up to the football game on Friday night.
Congratulations, Haley and Ben.
All right, let's have another big round of applause and congratulations for our underclassmen representatives.
All right, now we're going to introduce the parents of our 2009 homecoming court representatives. Steve and Jan Thomas, parents to Lauren. Rob and Nancy Coons are the parents of Alex.
Next up, we have Tom Breams and Doreen Anglin, the parents of Bailey Breams. And we have Kevin and Brenda Potus, the parents of Connor.
Next up, we have Brian and Denise Omlid, parents of Ann. And Terry and Carol Jastrom, parents of Ben.
All right, next up we have Rick and Julie Hansen, the parents of Callie. And Jim and Tara Brown, the parents of Noah.
Next up, we have Brad and Jill Staley, parents of Molly. And Darcy Husterlid is accompanied by her mother, Jane Husterlid Egan, and they are the mother and grandmother of Dominic. And Steve Ciafalo is Dominic's father, and he is joined by his wife, Nancy.
All right, now that we've met all the parents of our representatives and they're making their way to their seats, It's now time to meet our senior class representatives.
Our first nominees are Alex Koontz and Lauren Thomas. His classmates chose him to represent the class of 2010 because his mouth is always going so hard, so he's hard to miss, and people just tend to love him. Alex is involved with concert choir, executive chamber, and theater. The song that would best represent his life is Pretty Young Thing by Michael Jackson.
Ow!
Lauren says the song that best represents her life is It Happens by Sugarland. Lauren participates in soccer and basketball at RHS. Her favorite memory of RHS is the state basketball tournament because the team makes so many unforgettable memories, especially when Callie, Kim, Tiva, and Lauren won the dance-off. Congratulations, Alex and Lauren.
Our next nominees are Connor Potus and Bailey Breens. And Connor's favorite quote is, if it were easy, everybody would be doing it. His favorite memory of RHS was finishing the seventh Harry Potter book. And Connor's involved with football and track and thinks he was chosen to represent his class as a last resort kind of thing. Bailey's first thought when she heard her name at the nomination assembly was, oh no, my mummy wrapping is falling off. Bailey's involved with cross country, track, student council, senior class officers, and FCA. Her favorite part of RHS is running with her best friends every day after school, and Bailey's motto is, you can do anything you set your mind to. Congratulations, Connor and Bailey.
Next up, we have Ben Jastrom and Annie Omlid. Participates in football, basketball, and link crew at RHS. His first thought when he heard his name called at the nomination assembly was, do they mean my dad? He has two older brothers, Nate and Ryan, and his favorite memory of RHS was winning the state football title twice. Ben feels he was chosen to represent the class of 2010 because he's got spunk. Anne does her best to always smile and find positives in every person and situation, and that's why she believes she was chosen by her class. She is involved with volleyball, basketball, student council, link crew, FCA, and NHS. Her favorite quote is, stand and be strong, conquer with love, and fight like a girl. Congratulations, Ben and Anne. Congratulations to Ben and Anne.
Our next two seniors are Noah Brown and Callie Hansen. Noah has two sisters, Jasmine and Chloe, and is involved with concert choir, theater, and being the Teddy Roosevelt mascot at Roosevelt. Noah believes he was chosen to represent his class because he likes to have fun, and he's laid back like a lot of guys at Roosevelt, but most of all, he used hypnosis. His favorite memory of Roosevelt was traveling to New York City with the concert choir last February. Callie is very honored by this opportunity to represent her class of 2010, and she's involved with student council, basketball, FCA, and National Honor Society. The song that best represents her life is Smile by Uncle Cracker. Callie's favorite memories of Roosevelt are from the basketball trips with the Chickies. Congratulations, Noah and Callie.
And last, but certainly not least, we have Dominic Husterlitz-Ciaflo and Molly Staley. Dominic's first thought when he heard his name announced at the assembly was, if only Julia Burgstaller could see me now. Dominic has two older siblings, Kyle and Whitney. He is involved with student council and theater and believes his sense of ironic humor is the reason he was chosen to represent his class. Molly has an older sister, Morgan, and a younger sister, Maggie. She believes her incredibly advanced nunchuck skills are the reason she was chosen to represent the class of 2010. Molly is involved in volleyball, basketball, student council, link crew, salsa, concert choir, and is working on her first show in theater. Molly's motto is, be the change you wish to see in the world. Congratulations to Dominic and Molly. Mr. Lukens, what do you think my life motto should be?
Well, let's see. How about math? It's what's for dinner.
We'll keep thinking about that one.
What do you think mine should be?
I think yours should be hair. Way overrated. Yeah, I like it.
All right, the candidates are looking pretty comfortable. It looks like we have some slideshow stuff to do here in just a second. And so sit back and relax and enjoy this slideshow for our 2009 Homecoming Royalty.
Thank you.
like she's still got long legs. Holy smokes. Is that her dad? Oh my god. Oh, look at her. Oh my god. Oh.
We got another little piece of entertainment for you tonight. Candidates are getting ready to come off stage and get ready for a little performance. That's not the entertainment. That's the entertainment. And right here in front of you, we have Nicole Durham and Gina Hafner, Megan Hecht, and Larissa Rasmussen. So let's sit back and enjoy a little string quartet music this evening.
Thank you.
Thank you for that nice music, ladies. It was beautiful. I think the candidates are ready to strut their stuff, so let's not keep you in suspense any longer. Here are your seniors performing their royalty dance.
Thank you.
All right, and believe it or not, there's actually a talent show after that. That's hard to believe. Great job, you guys. That was a highlight. All right, we got a little housekeeping stuff to do before we do the announcing and the crowning of our homecoming royalty. I'd like to remind everyone that after the royalty is crowned, just to make things move smoothly for the rest of the night, we ask that just for a little while after that, that you stick around in the auditorium, so you have to get all the candidates, these folks, and also the underclassmen to the grand staircase to have their picture taken. If you look right across the hall, all of the royalty from the time we opened in 1991 are over there on the wall, so they need to get a quick picture with the photographer. And after they're done with that, you are free to congratulate them and take pictures and whatnot over in the commons area. They'll be available for pictures and autographs, I assume, you know, if you're going to sign autographs. And after the coronation, we want to keep you here for a while, and we want to kick you out because we want you to have to pay to get back in. It's kind of an interesting little ploy that we have here at Roosevelt. And once you are cleared out of here, you can re-enter to watch the talent show if you wish to do so, that's $5. You can get a ticket out there in the foyer, and there's a table out there with some faculty members that'll be selling tickets for you. So again, thanks for your cooperation, sticking around here for a little while so that these guys can get out and get their pictures taken.
Oh, Mr. Lucas got a phone call. I wonder who that could be.
Grace Lukens?
It's Grace Lukens.
Well, hi, Grace. This is your father. Is Dockery there with you, too?
Tom Dockery.
Tom Dockery behaving himself? He's not? Oh, he is. Okay. Well, your timing was actually perfect. Mrs. Wetlaufer and I are on stage at the, it was a talent show, but now we're doing the homecoming royalty thing. It's kind of ironic that you and Tom are actually together tonight. Should I worry about that? I worry about Tom, actually, Grace, is what I'm worried about. Okay.
Okay, so am I supposed to...
Are you guys supposed to make an announcement for us? Well, hold on. Let me put you up to a microphone. Let me see if anybody can hear you. Just a second.
Thanks.
We'll just take your word for it. Grace, who is the king this year?
It's Connor Potus.
Okay, is Tom there? I want to talk to Tom. Hey, Tom. Do you have any idea who our homecoming queen is for this year? Tom, I'm getting uncomfortable with Mrs. Butler. Make the announcement. Tom Dockery is proud to report that the 2009 homecoming queen is Miss Annie Omlett. Congratulations to both Annie and Connor, and thanks to all of you for being a part of this homecoming I almost say it's homecoming coordination as you walked over here. Coordination. Would you like to make an announcement, Dominic? Okay.
All right. Did you all appreciate the dance we had tonight? I would just like to thank our new homecoming queen for teaching us all those dance moves, because without her, the rest of us would have been lost. So let's thank Annie one more time.
Well, again, congratulations to Annie and Connor, and we hope you all enjoyed the show tonight, and make sure you come back for the talent show. You thought this was good. Wait till you see what's coming up. Have a good night, everyone. Thanks for coming.